Joining us now from Washington is CBS News political correspondent John Dickerson. John, good morning.
Good morning, Maggie.
We heard the president be pretty stern in his words to Karzai, whose corrupt administration has really hampered our efforts there to fight the Taliban. How much of a difference do you think this visit and those words will make?
Well, it's certainly a high-profile way to make the case there, but this is a long, slow, and intractable problem. The U.S. has been worried about this for a long time, and remember, we've got that July deadline where troops are supposed to start withdrawing. They can only withdraw if there's something to, if there's a government and a system in place to hand them over to. So this is important pressure, but the U.S. has had a lot of trouble putting pressure on Karzai in the past.
Here at home over the weekend, we saw the growing Tea Party movement kick off this 42-city protest tour against the passage of health care reform, with Sarah Palin leading the charge, promising the Democrats that the upcoming elections would be a referendum on health care reform. How worried do you think the Democrats are? Because this is a party that is growing. Look at the number of people there, and that has a ton of momentum.
Well, the worry is that conservatives and Tea Party activists are energized. And their key argument is that legislators in Washington and the president aren't listening to them. And now that this health care legislation has passed, that's a perfect piece of evidence in that complaint. And so what Democrats are worried about in particular is that the opposition, the conservatives, are just more energized, more exercised, and they'll turn out at the polls in November. What Democrats can only hope for is that Tea Party activists somehow overreach and that ends up becoming a stain on the Republican Party.
Right. And also, if you ask the Obama administration, they'll tell you maybe people will see the few health care changes that are taking effect immediately and actually like them, and it'll turn the tide of public opinion.
That certainly is the hope. The polling right now does not give the Obama administration a lot of encouragement on that front. The problem is that people are nervous about change, and this is an enormous change in their lives. And then, in addition to that, they saw a political process over a year that didn't give them much reason to be more confident. So now that it's passed, the president's out there stumping, trying to explain to people what's in this bill. The problem is people really just don't believe it yet.
And lastly, how about Sarah Palin campaigning for John McCain and against his more conservative opponent this weekend? You got to give her props for loyalty.
Indeed you do. They have maintained their relationship, even though there has been this extraordinary out in the open feud between Palin and lots of the top members of McCain's campaign. Ultimately, in that feud, McCain had to come out and say he still sort of stood behind the former leaders of his campaign. Anyway, all water under the bridge. She's now out there trying to help John McCain, who's in a very tough race.
All right, John Dickerson. Thanks so much, John.
Thanks, Maggie.
A lot happens early on The Early Show, weekday mornings on CBS.